seen the derivation of your electric field intensity at any point on your y-axis. It is not that we need to fix the point only on y-axis. You can place the point anywhere on x-axis or y-axis or z-axis if it is a Cartesian system, or rho phi z-axis in case of your cylindrical system, or r theta phi in case of your spherical system. Now, looking at this problem, derive an expression for your electric field intensity at any point P at a distance of h meter along the axis from one end of the conductor. The conductor is of length L meter, having a uniform charge density of rho L coulomb per meter. The difference between this problem and the previous problem what we have solved is, in the previous problem we need to identify the electric field intensity at any point on your y-axis. Here we need to identify the expression for your electric field intensity on the same axis from one end of the conductor at a distance of h meter. So just convert this given problem into your pictorial representation. So from the given problem it is understood that there is a conductor. The conductor length is A and B. We need to identify the electric field intensity at any point P at a distance of h meter along the axis from one end of the conductor. So here two ends of the conductors are there. One end of the conductor is A and the other end of the conductor is B. You can place the point P either considering B as your one end of the conductor or considering A as one end of the conductor. In this problem we have assumed A is placed at the origin and B is in other end of the conductor. From this end of the conductor we are placing the point P at a distance of h meter from one end of the conductor. So if this is going to be L and if this is going to be H, so whether it is an infinite length of the conductor or finite length of the conductor, we need to assume a differential elemental length. Finite length also we don't know, it may be of kilometer or it may be of megameter length. So we need to assume a differential elemental length at point C. So this point C is placed at a distance of z meter from the origin. So this is going to be my cos and it is going to be my effect. Why? Because this is the point where we need to identify my electric field intensity. So the distance between cos and effect is small r, or we can represent it with a term called d. This d is equal to, if this is going to be L meter, point C is placed at a distance of z meter from the origin. So from point C to point B is going to be L minus z. So the total length from point C to point P is L minus z plus h, so which we can call it as d or small r according to our notation. So that only we have explained it as in the form of a theory. Now here it is a line charge density, right? So we can consider line charge density is equal to, it is charge distributed throughout the length of the line, which is equal to, if you assume a differential elemental length, the charge distribution is also going to be differential. So we can write dq is equal to rho l into dl. Due to this differential charge distribution, the electric field intensity is also going to be differential. So we can write it as dE. We know that the electric field intensity E is equal to q divided by 4 pi epsilon r square. In this place, since we have represented the distance between cos and effect as d, we are writing it as d square into acp vector. Acp is nothing but unit vector between your cos and effect. C is the point cos and P is your effect point. So if your charge distribution is going to be differential, then the electric field intensity is also going to be differential, which we can write it as dE is equal to dq divided by 4 pi epsilon r square into acp vector. So dE is equal to, in the place of dq you substitute rho l into dl. So rho l dl, dl is nothing but differential elemental length. In the problem we have considered dl is equal to dz, so we can substitute it here, rho l dl dz divided by 4 pi epsilon d square. From this we can identify e. To remove this in differentiation, we have to integrate towards your right hand side. The integration takes place from where to where? You can move the point C from point A to point B. So the differential elemental length can be moved from point A to point B, whose distance is 0 to L meter, dz divided by d. In the place of d, we can write it as L plus h minus z, as I explained earlier. So let us consider this complete term, L plus h minus z as t. So t is if t is equal to l plus h minus z, then we need to say the boundary condition. Boundary condition in the sense, when your point C is placed exactly at point A, what is the boundary condition? If this point C is placed exactly at point B, what is your boundary condition? It means that when z is equal to 0 meter, what is the value of t, and when z is equal to l meter, what is the value of t, that we need to identify. So we have considered l plus h minus z as t when z is equal to 0. When you put z is equal to 0, t is equal to l plus h. When z is equal to l, so in the place of z, if you put l, l and l will get cancelled. So finally, we'll get t is equal to h. From this, we can identify dt is equal to dz, because l plus h is equal to a constant term, where this z is going to vary all along the length of the conductor. So now it is between 0 to l alpha. So we can write it as E is equal to rho L divided by 4 pi epsilon integration. When z is 0, what is the value of t we have obtained? L plus h. When z is equal to L, what is the value of t we have obtained? H. So the limit stands from L plus h to h. In between this, here minus dt divided by t square Az vector. After integration, we'll get E is equal to rho L divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 divided by h minus 1 divided by l plus h Az vector. The unit for electric field intensity is volt per meter. So this is how you need to derive your derivation. So in the previous derivation, at any point on your y-axis, the electric field intensity is rho l divided by 4 pi epsilon cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1 Ay vector plus sin theta 2 minus sin theta 1 into Az vector. Suppose if you wanted to identify the electric field intensity on the axis from one end of the conductor, means rho L divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 divided by h minus 1 divided by L plus h Az volt per meter. The unit for electric field intensity is volt per meter. Now next one. Determine. So far whatever derivations we have done, all done with respect to your Cartesian coordinate system. Now here we'll consider your cylindrical coordinate system. Determine the electric field intensity E at any point P due to the straight, infinite, long, uniform distributed charge wire in a cylindrical coordinate system. Now, as usual, here the charge density is placed parallel to your Z axis. It is an infinite long current carrying conductor. Place the point P on anywhere on your rho axis. As we know, it is in cylindrical coordinate system. The where exactly you are placing the point P, from there to your x-axis, the angle is phi. So the point P is placed at rho phi 0, and this is the point cos point. So in this, here we are going to assume a differential elemental length at point C. The ordinates of C is 0 comma phi comma z. It is placed at a distance of z meter from the origin. The distance between your cause and effect is going to be small r. Now we can identify the value of your electric field intensity. So rho L is equal to Q divided by L. So if you assume a differential elemental length, the charge distribution is also going to be differential, which we can write it as dQ. If the charge distribution is differential, then the electric field intensity is also going to be differential. So substitute one over the other and identify this equation. Now after this, we'll get dE equal to rho L dZ divided by 4 pi epsilon r square rho A rho minus z into Az divided by r. Here, looking at this figure, when you move this point C throughout this infinite length of the conductor, the value of z is going to get vary, which in turn the value or the distance between your cause and effect is going to get vary. Therefore, we need to identify what is my dz and what is my r from this triangle. From this triangle, in the sense, from this particular triangle, what is your cos theta? Cos theta is adjacent divided by hypotenuse. It is z divided by r. Sin theta is rho divided by r. Likewise, we need to identify. So cos theta is z divided by small r, and sin theta is rho divided by small r. So from this, you identify what is your z and what is your small r. And then here differentiate dz is equal to minus rho into cosecant square theta into d theta. Now you have to substitute this dz and r in the original equation. After substituting the dz and r in the original equation, you will get dE is equal to rho l minus rho cosecant square theta into d theta. In the place of dz, we need to substitute minus rho into cosecant square theta divided by 4 pi epsilon. In the place of r, we need to substitute rho into cosecant theta. So since we had rho cube here, r cube here, we can write it as rho cube into cosecant cube theta, and it is your unit vector rho into a rho minus z into az. So after simplifying, we'll get dE is equal to minus rho l divided by 4 pi epsilon into rho d theta sin theta a rho minus cot theta into az. Now point P, where exactly it is placed? On your rho axis. So as point P is symmetrical, your vertical component of E is can be neglected, and therefore the total E will only have rho component, because in this diagram the rho is placed only all along your rho axis. So you will get the electric field intensity only. Suppose if this is going to be like a cylindrical coordinate, if you place the point over here, then the value of electric field intensity will be all along your rho axis. Therefore the other component, in this a rho component we have, a z component we have. Since the point P is placed symmetrically, vertical component of E, that is a z, can be nullified, and therefore E will have only a rho component. After simplification, we'll get dE is equal to minus rho l divided by 4 pi epsilon rho into sin theta a rho vector. Here theta is nothing but it varies from 0 to pi. After simplifying, we'll get E is equal to rho l divided by 2 pi epsilon rho into a rho vector, where a rho is the normal vector perpendicular to the conductor passing through the point P. This is how you need to solve the problem.